Hi, I'm Lonnie. Glad you could join me for another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. This video is a little bit different than most of my videos on my channel. Most of my videos are about bushcraft and survival how-tos and skills. This video, I'm going on a couple of overnight survival trips. It's not so much a how-to. It's just, I'm going on a trip, and I thought you might want to come along. Okay, when I left the house, I walked out with just my knife, and on my knife, I carry some paracord. It's always on there in case I need it. And there's also a fire steel mounted here. I don't know if you can see that or not. And the only other things that I brought with me that I don't normally have with me all the time is I did bring a bow saw blade, and while out there I made a buck saw. Also had my shotgun. Okay, my shotgun was not to procure food, it was bear protection. Here in South Central Alaska, that's a wise choice. In the video, you'll see some scenes of wildlife that I encountered. Thought I might even need the shotgun once. Luckily, it turned out good and I didn't need it. But I was thankful I had it. But anyway, you'll see some scenes of Alaska and some scenes of wildlife. Come along with me and I hope you enjoy the trip.
Okay, I've found a place where I'm gonna pitch my shelter, and it's gonna be right underneath that spruce tree. I'm gonna clear out some branches and snuggle up right underneath that spruce tree to take advantage of the deep needles that have accumulated over the years. It should be a pretty warm bed, and the spruce boughs above will help shed the rain a little bit off of me. Right over here is a deadfall spruce that'll help block the wind. Okay, from where I chosen to put my shelter, just a short little walk. Right over here There. How's that? Kind of nice for sitting out here at night in the evening with a cup of tea, listening to the river down below me. That's great. It'll work out great. I was gathering materials for my lean-to and I looked up and discovered I was being watched. She's kind of hard to see through the trees, but it's a cow moose. See, I'm about 130 feet away from her, I guess. 140 feet. Well, back to finishing my shelter. Gotta get something thrown up before nightfall. Okay, I got my bow saw all put together. It's just waiting on the line. And I always carry 550 paracord on my knife sheath, so it's time to sacrifice that cord. Got the basic framework established here, set up, and I've started covering it with grass. This will be the front here. I built it I built it pretty small so I can get in there and bring in my shotgun with me for bear protection and my coat and hat and that stuff and not much more. Hopefully it's small enough that my body will heat it up if I insulate it good. I put the grass on here vertical like that so that if it does rain, the drips are going to run down the grass stalks and drip down and run down the next grass stalk and hopefully run off before they come into the shelter. Here's the meadow where I've been getting my grass. It's a beautiful spring day here in south central Alaska. Hopefully you can hear the birds. Okay, I'm in my meadow. I was gonna get grass when I heard some crash and brush. Then I heard some woofing. Something was woofing at me. I jacked a shell and the shotgun got ready. I think it's a moose, but I don't know. Could be a bear. It's down this way somewhere. It stopped when I jacked the shell and the gun. I'll see if move around a little bit and see if I can see what it is. Okay, it's whatever it is, it's off over this way. I heard some more brush cracking. It sounded like a hoofed animal. Wasn't trying to sneak up on me then. So it's probably a bull, moose. I got up on a high vantage point here, but visibility is limited due to the thick brush cover down below. Makes me glad that I brought my short barrel pistol grip shotgun. Okay, well, I think the crisis is over. So, back to gathering grass.